Are you looking to classify if a change is physical or chemical? Or you might be wondering, what is physical change and what is chemical change? Well, we're going to answer all of these in this video. Hi, I'm Dr. K and welcome to Chem Simplified. Let's jump straight in with the definitions of physical change. It's a change that goes from one form to the other. It doesn't involve any change to the chemical identity, meaning its chemical composition. So it's still the same substance after the change. So the effect that we see is only on the physical properties. And generally, that change is easily reversible. So let me use an example to illustrate physical change. Melting of ice. So let's think of ice. Before melting, it's solid, H2O. After melting, it's liquid, H2O. In terms of its physical properties, it has changed from solid state to liquid state. But in terms of its chemical identity or the chemical property, there was no change to it. It was H2O before melting, it's still H2O after melting. So there's no change in its chemical identity, meaning it's still the same substance. The only change that we notice is the effect on its physical properties, changing from solid state to liquid state. Also, we can easily reverse this process by simply taking the melted ice, which is the water, place it in the freezer, and it'll freeze again to become ice. So that basically illustrates physical change. Now we move on to chemical change. Chemical change is a little bit different from physical change. It's a change that's accompanied by a change in its chemical identity, meaning before and after the change, it is not the same substance. It forms new substance. And the effect that we see is going to be on both physical and chemical properties. And usually it's very difficult to reverse the change. So let me use an example, burning paper. So if you imagine before burning the paper, so you have a piece of paper, after you light it out, it burns and it burns into ashes. So before burning, it was a piece of paper, solid, and after burning, it becomes a smaller piece of paper. So there's a change that we observe in its physical properties. In terms of its chemical properties, it changes its identity entirely. It was paper before burning, and then after that, it became ash after burning. Ash is not paper, it's a new substance. Also, I can't reverse the change, meaning I can't turn the ash back into paper. So that basically illustrates chemical change. Let's go through some of the things I did this morning and classify them as physical or chemical change. So the first thing I did this morning after waking up was brushing my teeth. Now my toothpaste has fluoride ion in it. So when I brush my teeth, the fluoride ion in the toothpaste changed the chemistry of my teeth. And what that did was it strengthened my teeth and helped prevent future cavities from forming. So technically speaking, that forms a new substance on my teeth. Also, that process is not reversible. So brushing teeth is a chemical change. After brushing my teeth, I hit the shower. Since it was a hot shower, steam started forming. So what happens when hot water changes to steam? Well, there's an obvious change in its physical properties from liquid state to gas state. However, the chemical identity is still the same. It's still H2O. So steam forming in the shower is a physical change. After shower, I head down for breakfast. So I pull out an apple and washed it. Since after washing the apple, it didn't change to another fruit, it's therefore still the same substance. So washing apple is a physical change. Same thing goes to cutting the apple. It only changed in size and it's still apple, so cutting apple is a physical change. Then I decided to fry an egg, because apple is just not enough. So the heat from the pan causes the structure of the protein in the egg to change permanently. That process is actually called protein denaturing. Since this change is not reversible and the protein structure of my egg has changed permanently, so frying an egg is a chemical change. Now, I don't know about you, but my morning is not complete without coffee. So I grinded some coffee beans. Grinding coffee beans only involves change in its appearance, meaning it changed from whole beans to coffee grounds. Since after grinding, it's still the same substance, which is coffee, it's therefore physical change. After grinding the beans, I brewed a cup of coffee. So what happened was there was a transfer of taste and smell from the coffee grounds to the hot water through an extraction, which is a chemical reaction. So that means My water was no longer just water. It became the elixir of life, which is coffee. So brewing coffee is a chemical change. While taking a sip of coffee, I accidentally spilled my coffee on the table. So I got a piece of paper towel from the kitchen. Tearing the paper towel from its holder only changed its appearance from a roll of paper towel to a piece of paper towel. It's still the same paper towel. So that means tearing paper towel is a physical change. Then I used that piece of paper towel to wipe the coffee that I spilled. So after wiping, coffee was absorbed onto the paper towel. But the chemical identities of both my coffee and my paper towel remain the same. Paper towel is still paper towel, and the coffee is still coffee. It's just absorbed onto the paper towel. I can easily reverse this process. What I can do is I take my piece of paper towel that has coffee on it, soak it in water, take it out, and let it dry. So I'll get back my paper towel, and my coffee is left in that water, right? But of course, I wouldn't drink that coffee anymore. Since it's reversible, and the substances remain the same, therefore, it's a physical change. Unfortunately, after breakfast, I had to wash my dishes. When I washed the dishes, a chemical reaction occurred between the detergent and the mess on the dishes. So that means the substance before and after washing are no longer the same. The dish detergent is no longer the same. The chemical makeup of the mess on my plate has changed as well. So washing dishes is a chemical change. Just to recap, here's what we have classified from what I've done this morning before recording this video. Like I've mentioned before, when classifying change is to ask whether a new substance was formed. If yes, then it's a chemical change. If no, then it's a physical change. Hope you find this video helpful. Do subscribe and check out my other videos. For more practice questions on classifying physical and chemical changes, head over to chemsimplified.com. I'll post the blog link below. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.